Moving on to Article 5, Paragraph 3. This basically deals with what are some of the preparatory or auxiliary activities which are not treated as a permanent establishment under the India-USA Treaty. Now, let's first read it and then we'll come to the explanation. Notwithstanding the preceding provision of this article. Now, what this means is that this particular clause or paragraph overrides paragraph 1 and 2, which means that even if there is a fixed place of business in India, even if it is included within the examples of paragraph 2, if the activities as such are something which is covered under paragraph 3, it would not amount to a PE. Even for agency PE, which you are going to see subsequently in paragraph 4 and 5, if the activities carried out by the agent falls under the purview of these very activities, then also the view is that it should not result into a formation of PE. So notwithstanding the preceding provisions of this article, the term permanent establishment shall be deemed not to include any one or more of the following. So either of them or even a combination of them, right, will not be treated as a PE. But if you do one of these activities and alongside you do something else which constitutes a PE, in that case, the profitability of the entire transaction may risk being taxed, right? So let's go through them one by one. The use of facilities solely, which means only. If you're using for some other purpose, exemption is not available. For the purpose of storage, display, or occasional delivery of goods or merchandise belonging to the enterprise. So if there is a foreign company, it has a place in India where it stores, right, or displays, or at times occasionally delivers goods or merchandise which belong to this enterprise. The goods should belong to the foreign company. If it is selling goods from here for someone else, a third party, then this exemption is not available. But if you are doing this for your own goods or merchandise, the exemption is available and such an activity is not going to result into a PE. The maintenance of stock of goods or merchandise belonging to the enterprise solely for the purpose of storage, display, or occasional delivery of goods, right? So one, you are using a facility, maybe an office, etc., a godown, etc. Second, you are maintaining stock of goods or merchandise, right? But these goods or merchandise should belong to the enterprise, and the sole purpose of such a stocking of goods should be storage, display, or occasional delivery. The maintenance of stock of goods or merchandise belonging to the enterprise solely for the purpose of processing by another enterprise. So if there's a foreign company, there's a contract manufacturer in India, right? If the goods are stored here for the purpose of processing by this company, and after processing, they go to the foreign company, then such a storage of goods, the maintenance of stock of goods or merchandise belonging to the enterprise will not result into a PE. Again, the fourth one, maintenance of fixed place of business solely for the purpose of purchasing goods or merchandise or of collecting information for the enterprise. So if you are just engaged in the purpose of purchasing goods in India, then it will not be treated as a PE. But when let's again the same thing for the enterprise, if there's a commission agent who procures goods in India for third party and this commission agent has a PE in India or he is maintaining a fixed place of business in India, right? In his case, the commission income that he gets will be taxable in India because he's procuring it for someone else, not for the enterprise itself. Or of collecting information. So let's say there are news channels, media channels, overseas one. if they collect some information in India and they have an office whose job is to just collect this information, they will not be treated as having a PE, as long as the information is collected for the news channel themselves. But if there's a freelance journalist over here, okay, and he has an office through which he collects information and then sells it to someone else, then the profits of that person will be taxable in India. The maintenance of his place of business solely for the purpose of advertising, okay, for supply of information, for scientific research, or for other activities which have a preparatory or auxiliary character for the enterprise. Now, what this means here is, you need to see the nature of business of the foreign company. See what are the other activities which are being carried out. Are these activities vis-a-vis the nature of business of preparatory or auxiliary character? If yes, they are excluded from the definition of the